With this example, I want to explore a basic method of sculpting with the brushes we've talked about so far in the previous video, and show you how you could use what you have discovered so far. I would strongly advise you to start with a simple project for your first practice sculpt, which will allow you to freely sculpt and design something without the constraints of trying to be too accurate. I'm going to take the practice mesh that we've used in our previous discussions, and instead of starting over, show you how easy it is to take this mesh and reshape it into something new. My goal at this point is to make some sort of stylized head or slightly cartoony character. So to get started, I'm just going to smooth out some of the details that I have left over here. So pressing the shift key and drawing over these areas to slightly smooth them out. And I'm not too concerned with leaving some of this behind, as we'll go over and sculpt on top of this. So I'm switching to the clay buildup, and I'm changing my draw size as well as my Z intensity. And I'm just going in and lightly carving in and building up on top of the surface. So carving in by pressing the Alt key. And then I'm going in here and I'm just sculpting just a little bit thicker area for where the eyes will be. So I'm starting to change some of those things that I've done, building up for the brows, and I'm actually going to go in here and carve away some of these areas. There's no reason why we can't change these, and we can start to define some of the brows. And then I want to put in some of the major landmarks. So the first one's going to be the eyes. Now pressing the Alt key, with a small draw size, I'm going in and just carving out the shape and adjusting to an even smaller size to really get a nice, fine, and controlled line. And we're carving out this area, and then we'll go in and we'll just keep smoothing and carving. And then I'm just using clay buildup and just building more of a round shape for the eyeball. So just starting to build it up and smooth out a little bit of those details, and then we can easily start to round this shape. So as we continue to round it out, then we'll go in and we'll keep our draw size really small, but we'll start to crease and create a more fine and controlled line for the eyelid. So as far as how the eye sits, we want to start to round this out. And as we start to create the shape here, just using the clay buildup brush, and we can continue to move on, and let's go in and sculpt out the nose area. So using clay buildup still, building up the nostrils, pressing Alt to carve in these nostril holes here. And then we can change the Z intensity to make this a little bit stronger and smooth out as we need to. Now, I'm just continuing to use clay buildup to carve away and build up the shapes. So I'm building up an area that'll be a much thicker jaw than what I had defined in the previous sculpt. So you can see how easy it is just by changing the intensity to create more of a sketch-like surface. And once we've got those areas defined, let's move on and change some of the major shapes with the Move brush. So I'm using the Move brush here to make these very large movements. So I'm making my draw size very large, and I'm going in and looking at different angles here. So you can see how we can start to shape the character by first laying in some foundation sculpting with the clay buildup brush, and then moving these things around with the Move brush. So we can change the arch of the nose, and we can go in here and make it more of a bulbous-like shape for the nose, make it more cartoony or stylized. So just pushing and pulling, and now we can really go in and start to lay in that spherical shape for the eyeballs. So I'm just starting to get the type of shape that I want for the eyes. And what really helps here is to look at different angles and go underneath, and we can start to get that round overlap shape there for the top of the eyelid. So continuing to shape here with the Move brush and just redefining some of these areas to get a better overall silhouette for this character's face. And once we've got a good shape here, we'll just continue to shape the top of the head a little bit more. Then we can break away and start to go in and start to define more of these areas. So the next one I want to define is the mouth. So I'm going to switch back to the clay buildup, and just as we did with the eyes, we can just quickly go in and press Alt and just start carving in the shape of what the mouth would be. So I'm thinking of doing this as more of an expression character, and I want to give him a shocked or surprised expression maybe. So I'm carving out what would be the inner mouth just to get some definition and depth between those two. And then once we get that in there, we can go in and start to smooth some of these things by pressing Shift. And then now I'll go in with the clay buildup and I'll add to the surface to create the definition for the lips. So just building around in the shapes of the lips, you can see how we can actually create the definition of the lip just by sculpting very finely with a small brush size. And then we'll continue to do that for the bottom lip. So once we've got a decent shape here, let's go back and redefine and move things back around. So switching back to the move brush and just pulling the upper lip out and starting to just create more of a accurate shape to the expression that I want. So you can see the combination of using clay buildup to define an area and then going back with the move brush to reshape and form all of this. And then we can go back and use the clay buildup brush to redefine those areas that we just moved around. So I'm starting to get more focused on getting these shapes. So going back to the clay buildup with a smaller brush size to define the edges or creases of the lips, and then smoothing out some of those details. Now let's start to change the expression again and use the move brush. So we're going to raise his eyebrows up and start to get more of that shocked or surprised expression. As I'm moving things around with the move brush, I'm looking for new areas that need to be worked on. So quickly switching back to the clay buildup brush and reform these areas to better match the expression. After moving and shaping the eyes, I can now go back with the clay buildup and not only add to the surface, but also press Alt to carve around the eyelids and also to the top and bottom of the eyelids to create more thickness and depth. Now, breaking away from the move and clay buildup brushes, I'll switch to the damn standard brush to create these nice and strongly defined edges around the eyelid. A nice trick to refine the outer lids is to press the Alt key and use this brush to build that crease line outwards in order to create more separation between the eyeball and the eyelid. Now let's go in and actually create the iris for the character. So I'm going to use the standard brush and I'm just going in and pressing Alt with a smaller draw size to carve in that area. And lastly, let's add some more stylized effects. So I'll switch back to the damn standard brush, and by pressing the Alt key again, we can add this strong crease line on the nose, also applying the same techniques at the bridge of the nose by also pressing Alt to add to the surface to have more of an interesting break, almost as if he maybe broke his nose at some point. Then quickly switching back to the move brush to pull and push these areas around further. Now, one final detail I want to add is put some hair in this character. So I'm using the clay buildup brush because it has that nice texture, and I'm just going in and starting to build up around what would be the eyebrows. So we can continue with a small brush stroke and just softly go in here and build up the surface. Now we can keep moving further and give the character a beard. And I'm just sculpting in the direction in which the hair would flow for a character's beard and just creating some kind of flow by using a small draw size to go in here and create these separations of these strokes. And then we'll move up to the character's hair, so we can start here at the top, so continuing to rotate around, and then go in here and start to do the same effect. So just building up in a direction, creating, you know, the flow or where the parts of the character's hair would be, and then we can change our draw size to be a little bit larger. So I'm defining shape for the hair by using a small draw size and applying various strokes in a direction that follows the flow I initially laid down. And then going through and adjusting my draw size constantly to get a clear separation of each brush stroke to resemble smaller strands or groups of hair. And then we'll put some finishing touches on the beard, but you can see that just with a few standard brush strokes and controls, we can follow just using the move brush, the clay buildup brush, and the damn standard brush to really start to create a workflow and sculpt with our character. So you can see with just a few brushes, we can create a very simple workflow to follow, mainly by laying in foundation landmark details with the clay buildup, damn standard, and standard brush, and then switching back and forth between those brushes, and then using the move brush to make these large movements, and constantly adjusting things around to get those shapes that fit the design we were searching for. One last little nugget of information that will help us in designing and sculpting even further is the symmetry feature. So far, I've been sculpting with the symmetry feature enabled in ZBrush. By hovering over the mesh, you can see this little red dot just underneath my brush cursor, and there's also the little dot on the left side as well, which shows us we are sculpting with symmetry on both sides of the mesh. Of course, at the beginning stages of sculpting and trying to work quickly in your design, when you've reached a point of completion by getting all of the major shapes on the sculpt, we can then disable symmetry for additional levels of flexibility with your sculpt, as well as more creative controls as an artist. This can mean changing the expression or pose of the character, as well as adding asymmetrical details that will bring life into our character. Let's take a moment now to disable symmetry and go in here and add some quick adjustments to this guy. To disable symmetry, press the X key on the keyboard. Now, if we hover our cursor over the mesh, you can see that our symmetry is disabled. And now we can go in and make our adjustments. I'm starting off by switching to the move brush to very quickly break the symmetry of his face. And I want to change the expression to be something a bit more interesting. So I'm going in with a fairly large draw size. And you can see that with a larger draw size, we can affect more of the sculpt area. So pulling one side up and one side down, if we change the smirk here, you can see that it's also affecting the cheek as well as the nose. So we can start to give him more of a smirk or a smile. And then we can really go in here and use navigation to scale closer and go in with a smaller draw size for the move brush and start to refine and shape this expression. And then going in and really getting up close here, you can see that we can start to create more of that crease edge at the edge of the lip. Now let's focus on the eyes, and you can see with a smaller draw size as well, we can change the shape of the right eye, and then go in and change the shape of the left. With a nice asymmetrical adjustment to the eyes, now I want to go in and create more definition based on the parts of the expression that I've just moved around. I'm using the damn standard brush because it has the strong line to carve around the cheek to really make the skin of the character's face feel like it's moving and wrinkling around the cheekbone. It helps to visualize the entire mesh as we move things around and find areas where we can really make the details pop by creating more depth between different surface levels, for example, like the crease line we've added at the cheek here. I'm going back to the eyes to start adding to the surface to make those details pop even more as well. So now instead of the damn standard brush, I'm using the standard brush to build up the eyelid because it has a softer fall off of the brush stroke, and I can softly go in and add some wrinkles across the eyelid. I'm using this brush with a small draw size and a very low Z intensity because it's easier to add these softer lines to visualize how this will work without the need to smooth out the surface too much and destroy our hard work while sculpting. And then later go in and redefine them with a stronger intensity for the final details. Now I'm going to switch to the move brush and just go in and reshape this eye, just to get more of that spherical shape as the eyelid sits on the eyeball, so we can start to just control this a little bit further. So each time we make an adjustment somewhere else, we can switch to our move brush or clay buildup brush, whichever brush works best for us. So now we're going in to add those final details in stronger lines with the damn standard brush. I'm following all of the strokes I initially laid down with the standard brush around the eye wrinkles, and continuing to add those down the cheek and around the entire eye to clearly define them more. So now is a good time to scale outwards from the mesh and visualize the whole surface to add final touches on other areas and follow these same ideas of defining all areas of the sculpt by using the standard brush or damn standard brush or any of these brushes you feel most comfortable with laying in these final asymmetrical details. No matter what it is you decide to create with these tools, these same general guidelines will apply and help you to break down your sculpting process into stages to sculpt efficiently. Once you have disabled the symmetry option and apply major asymmetrical changes to the sculpt, as I've done here, When we turn Symmetry on to Sculpt again, you'll find that we are no longer working with a perfectly symmetrical mesh, and can be a little tricky to sculpt on both sides, as you may like. So, a very simple method to follow here is to work in stages. First, especially at the beginning stages of sculpting, we'll be working with Symmetry enabled, in order to quickly and efficiently shape our mesh, and then go in and make a smart decision on when to turn it off, in order to save you the time and effort sculpting with an asymmetrical mesh. The entire free sculpting process was about 20 minutes of sculpting, but don't worry, although this portion was time-lapsed just a bit, we've also provided the full video of sculpting for you to watch and follow along as you choose. You can find it as a separate video inside of this series. Remember, when you're completed with the project or need to take a break, to save your project. We can press the Quick Save button to save, or press the 9 key on the keyboard, and this will put our project directly into the Quick Save folder, which we can find inside of Lightbox. And of course, you can also save manually to a different location by navigating to the File menu here, or by pressing Ctrl S on the keyboard. Remember, for those on the Macintosh, press Command S on the keyboard. So that covers the basics of getting us started with sculpting. I recommend now that you take at least 20 or 30 minutes to just have some fun and do some free sculpting. Maybe sculpt your favorite comic book character or your cat, Sergeant Pepper, or whatever it may be. With just a little bit of practice, you will see how quickly you can start creating and making art with ZBrush. In the next part of this series, we'll be covering how to change materials and color adjustments for a more personalized experience while sculpting. If you have additional ZBrush-related questions on getting started, don't forget to continue exploring the Z Classroom library or visit the Ask ZBrush section on our YouTube channel. And send us specific questions on Twitter by posting a question with hashtag AskZBrush. Thanks for visiting Z Classroom, and I'll see you in the next video.